Hello to all of you. We are in a period of great concern and uncertainty over the impact of the novel coronavirus in West Virginia and throughout our nation and our world. I want to assure you, as bishop of this diocese that spans our great state, that I am in constant prayer with you and for you as we face this unprecedented time. I realize it is particularly challenging that we are forced to remain apart during this holy season of Lent, a time when we are used to gathering often in prayer, in reflection, and in penance as we await the joy of the Lord's resurrection. We are experiencing for a short time what millions of our fellow Christians experience for years on end because they live in areas of the world where the Christian faith is forbidden or its free exercise severely restricted. How long we'll be required to keep our churches closed and remain apart is still unknown. As such, I urge you to make time each day for prayerful reflection, alone or with family members, and in a spirit of true solidarity with your fellow Catholics who are also deprived of our sacramental life during this time. Traditional devotions such as the recitation of the Rosary and the Divine Mercy Chaplet can be done together or individually. Or a family could simply read a short passage of scripture, perhaps taken from one of the daily Mass readings. Let each person present give a short reflection, offer some petitions for the sick and those who care for them, and end with an Our Father. We would do well to remember that the Lord abides with us always and in every place and is not hindered by physical boundaries. He seeks to be with us, to comfort us, and to speak to us in our prayerful reflection in the quiet of our souls. I urge you to use this time when we are forced to disconnect from our daily routine to reflect on and renew your commitment to Christ Jesus as his disciples journeying with him to the cross on Calvary. Technology offers you the ability to join the Mass that is live streamed from the Cathedral of St. Joseph here in Wheeling each day at 12:05 p.m. Sunday Mass is also live streamed at 6 p.m. on Saturday and remains on our diocesan website until Monday. We are also utilizing social media to make available a number of resources to help people of the diocese remain firm in their faith during this time. These include links to the daily readings, special prayers, and other reflections that we are pleased to share with you as aids in your own spiritual exercises. As a community of faith, we have a special obligation to follow the guidelines that have been issued by our public officials in order to protect our older adults and those most vulnerable to the severe effects of the coronavirus. For this reason, I not only have suspended the public celebration of Mass, but I also dispense all Catholics residing in West Virginia from the obligation to attend Sunday Mass for as long as this pandemic continues. I do ask that you keep in your prayers those who have contracted this virus here in our own country and across the globe, that God may comfort families who have lost a loved one, that those stricken might soon recover their health. We pledge to you to do our very best to stay connected and to continue to provide you spiritual resources and the assurance of our prayers during this Lenten journey that has taken us to an unpredictable place. We do not yet know the impact that these restrictions will have on our Holy Week celebrations, including our Easter Vigil and the Easter Sunday Mass liturgies. We will communicate further with you at the earliest opportunity when we see the road ahead more clearly. Let me now offer you this today's readings, a passage from Psalm 25. Your ways, O Lord, make known to me. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior. Remember that your compassion, O Lord, and your kindness are from of old. In your kindness, remember me because of your goodness, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice. He teaches the humble his way. The Lord forgets us not and is our constant guide and teacher in the ways of his righteousness. He shows us the way to his truth and is with us always, even in the darkest hours. May the Lord comfort and sustain you and your friends and loved ones in these difficult days and enliven our hope with the promise of his strength and constant presence. God bless you all. And may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.